I told the priest my questions, and he couldn't give me a clear answer. If the religion of Islam was portrayed as this bad, why are more and more people converting to Islam? I decided to buy a Quran, and I started to read it. As a Muslim revert, I want to share my story with you all. Originally, I grew up as a Catholic, but I never connected with the religion. I read the Bible and some things didn't make sense to me. I told the priest my questions and he couldn't give me a clear answer.
Lahir dan besar di Barat, Robin 5 begitu ia memperkenalkan diri dalam akun TikToknya, habis-habisan disuapin dengan pemberitaan media bahwa Islam identik dengan sesuatu yang tidak baik, Islam agama yang buruk dan sebagainya. Tapi ada satu artikel yang masih melekat dalam benaknya yang pernah ia baca, kalau Islam adalah agama dengan pertumbuhan tercepat di dunia. Artikel ini selalu mengganggu pikirannya, dan membuat pertanyaan untuk dirinya. Jika agama Islam digambarkan seburuk ini oleh media, mengapa semakin banyak saja orang yang masuk Islam?
Growing up in the West, the media showed that Muslims were bad people. However, something stuck out to me. I remember reading an article that stated that Islam was the fastest growing religion in the world. Another thing I discovered was that apparently prison guards were telling stories that inmates who genuinely truly changed as a person were the ones who reverted to Islam. So naturally I thought to myself, if the religion of Islam was portrayed as this bad, evil religion, why are more and more people converting to Islam? So for about 3 years, on and off, I was slowly but surely studying the religion of Islam more and more. And it was up until last year that things really started to change for me. I started seeing more and more videos of people talking about the beautiful religion of Islam, and I just see more and more people reverting to Islam. So I did this in secret. I decided to buy a Quran and I started to read it. It took me about a month to read it, and everything just clicked for me. The Quran challenges you to think.
Tepat sekali. Al-Quran seringkali mengajak umat manusia untuk berpikir, merenung, dan menggunakan akal mereka. Ini juga yang membedakan Islam dengan kepercayaan lainnya, yang melupakan menggunakan akal pada saat berhadapan dengan prinsip tauhid. Ini karena Islam mengajarkan bahwa akal adalah salah satu anugerah terbesar dari Allah, yang membedakan manusia dari makhluk lainnya. Lalu apa alasannya? Mengapa Al-Quran mengajak kita untuk berpikir? Mengenali kebenaran, Al-Quran mendorong umat manusia untuk berpikir, agar mereka dapat mengenali tanda-tanda kebesaran Allah di alam semesta. Dengan berpikir, manusia dapat menyadari adanya Tuhan yang Maha Esa dan memahami kebenaran ajarannya. Menghindari taklid buta, Al-Quran mendorong manusia untuk tidak hanya mengikuti tradisi atau kepercayaan tanpa pemahaman. Pemikiran kritis membantu seseorang untuk tidak terjebak dalam taklid buta atau mengikuti secara membabi buta, dan memastikan bahwa iman dan amal mereka didasarkan pada pengetahuan dan pemahaman yang benar. Memperdalam keimanan, dengan berpikir, merenung, dan mengkaji ayat-ayat Al-Quran, seseorang dapat memperdalam keimanannya. Pemikiran yang mendalam akan membawa seseorang kepada kekaguman yang lebih besar terhadap kebesaran Allah dan kesempurnaan ciptaannya. Mencapai kemajuan ilmu pengetahuan, Al-Quran menginspirasi manusia untuk mengembangkan ilmu pengetahuan. Banyak ayat dalam Al-Quran yang mengajak manusia untuk merenungi fenomena alam, langit, bumi, dan segala yang ada di dalamnya. Ini mendorong kemajuan ilmu pengetahuan dan teknologi, yang pada gilirannya bermanfaat bagi umat manusia.
It answered all the questions that I had. At this point, I wanted to revert and become a Muslim. But something was holding me back, and it was, what would my family think about this? During this time, I was also struggling financially as well as in school. So I felt lost. I felt like it was the end of the world. And then I decided, you know what? I'm gonna visit a masjid. So I went to the nearest masjid, and at first, nobody was there. I couldn't enter it, so I left. The next day, I decided to go back and try again. So the next day, I went back, and still, there was nobody there. At this point, I was having some serious doubts, and I thought to myself, maybe this isn't for me.
Memecahkan masalah dan membuat keputusan yang bijak. Pemikiran yang matang memungkinkan seseorang untuk mengambil keputusan yang bijaksana dalam kehidupan sehari-hari, baik dalam masalah duniawi maupun ukhrawi. Al-Quran mengajarkan pentingnya menggunakan akal untuk memecahkan masalah dan menemukan solusi yang adil dan benar.
And before I left, mind you, I was never gonna come back. I said, Allah, please give me a sign. And as I was about to leave, a car pulls up. And it was a fellow Muslim brother. So I decided to go up to him and I asked him, can I talk to somebody here? And mashallah, this fellow brother invited me into the masjid. He showed me around and he gave me a free copy of the Quran in Arabic. He asked me if I was interested in Islam. I told him yes. The next day, I came back and I met the Imam at the masjid. And alhamdulillah, we had a very beautiful discussion. In my heart, I knew this was the right choice. A couple weeks later, I decided to take my shahada and alhamdulillah, I became a Muslim. Fast forward 7 months later.
Menjalankan amanah sebagai khalifah di bumi. Allah menciptakan manusia sebagai khalifah di bumi, yang berarti manusia memiliki tanggung jawab untuk menjaga, mengelola, dan memakmurkan bumi. Untuk menjalankan amanah ini, diperlukan pemikiran yang kritis, kreatif, dan bijaksana.
The Almighty Allah found me lost and He guided me to the straight path. And mashallah, my life is so much better now as a Muslim.
You want success, you want happiness, you want joy, you want contentment. Allah says the solution is to come to pray. If you are connected with Allah, Allah has the key to the door of your success. Hayya ala al-falah, come to success. Who is telling you come to success? Wallahi, it is your maker, Allah.